Let's talk about sex. If that made you turn down the radio, or if it brought up feelings of anxiety, you're not alone. And a festival in Winnipeg this weekend aims to change that. The Sacred Sexual Music Festival wants to reduce guilt, shame, and repression around intimacy through music and workshops. Wendy Demos is the founder and organizer of the festival, which started in Vancouver last year. And Alana Dane is a local certified sexologist, and she's speaking at the festival on Sunday. They join me in studio. Hello.
Hello.
So, Wendy, why did you start this festival?
For a variety of reasons. One was I had taken what's called an intimacy educator training in Salt Spring Island outside of Vancouver. And it was so filled with aha moments. For example, one of the things the teacher said at the beginning was, you know, our sexuality is as innocent as breath. Mm-hmm. And that felt so profound to me. In fact, I included it in a song I wrote. But, and so just a variety of reasons. That was one. I just wanted to share the aha moments that I experienced at that training as well. At the same time, it was Me Too movement and Harvey Weinstein era. And it seemed there was a void was created. You know, what are we going to do now? Can we even flirt? So I really wanted to bring something that the sacredness of our sexuality back, the respect, the honor.
And did you find that the Me Too movement, you were saying, can we even flirt, but did it affect you personally in other ways?
The Me Too movement, I have my own story of, you know, inappropriate things that have happened to me throughout mm-hmm. my life. I didn't include them. I didn't share them on social media. Mm-hmm. However, I'm sure on some level they influenced me to bring this healthy way of looking at our sexuality into this festival.
And this was, of course, the first one was in Vancouver.
Yes, in 2018.
Right. And Alana, why is talking about sexuality so taboo?
Well, a lot of people have shame around it. They have guilt and shame either because of their upbringing. Their religious or cultural upbringing can cause a lot of shame around their own sexuality. So something as natural as their sexuality being part of whoever you are as a human being then starts to bring shame to them and pain.
And possibly if it's not religion, there could be other triggers?
Absolutely, yeah. So developmental trauma has a huge part to play in that sort of thing. So as a child, if you were sexually molested or abused, we'll have bearing definitely on who you become as an adult and how you deal with things. And everyone's different how they deal with those things. Has to do a lot with the nervous system. So there's a lot of science behind it. So what I'll be teaching there is the science behind the traumas that people have experienced and the shame that they feel and how that affects them emotionally and physically.
You mentioned how organized religion can sometimes lead to feelings of shame. Mm-hmm. And you grew up as a Jehovah's Witness. What was that like?
I usually equate it to Catholicism. It's very similar in its shame and guilt that you're going to be burned in hell as a Catholic, and as a Jehovah's Witness, you won't get into paradise if you have sex before marriage. And there's quite a bit around what you should do and what you shouldn't do.
And how did you manage to change your views?
Well, I knew there was more. Even as a teenager, I renounced my religion and went looking at many different religions and found that the theme was very similar in a lot of them regarding our sexuality. So I finally met someone when I lived in Central America who was teaching me Tantra, Tibetan mm-hmm. Tantra, and mm-hmm. the spirituality connection with our sexuality and how it's just normally part of us that we've been repressing in this society.
Well, and you mentioned you're going to be talking about the science behind shame, mm-hmm. so to speak. Are there ways that people can heal from
yes.
sexual trauma?
Absolutely. So we do have a lot of people seeking out talk therapy, which can be good to a point. But the more you talk about an incident like that, those feelings, those emotions keep coming up. So you're reliving almost the incident if you have a memory of a traumatic incident. So teaching people what trauma is and how it affects, and then giving them solutions on how to deal that and actually clear those blocks and those emotions so they can get through their life without being triggered all the time.
And Wendy, if I can get back to you for a moment, what else can people expect from the festival? Speakers like Alana and I guess a lot of good talking, but what else?
Well, I'm looking at it as a whole as a sweet revolution that we're all taking part in. And there'll be music, uplifting music throughout the day, informative talks, tables offering information, and amazing workshops, a shamanic experience. Somebody will be talking about the link between spirituality and sexuality. Just a total variety.
And maybe harking back to the one in 2018, how have people reacted to the festival? What have people said to you?
They are so amazed about it. First of all, when I first said, you know, I want to bring this Sacred Sexual Music Festival to Vancouver, and it was a moment of silence, and then yes. Mm-hmm. You know, it's everybody knows we need to shift this sexuality paradigm. It's so important. And for example, a Syrian refugee, she was here as a rainbow refugee. She's
a
lesbian in Vancouver.
In Vancouver, yeah.
And mm-hmm. she sent me an email. And she said, I'm so glad you're holding this festival. Yeah. I'm from Syria. I'm a refugee. I'm lesbian as well. She said, we could not talk about this. The only thing we had was porn to get educated mm-hmm. around sexuality in mm-hmm. Syria. So I welcome immigrants, welcome, you know, newly divorced, people who keep themselves isolated, people like that. Please, please yeah. come.
And is there a bit of a buzz around this? What are you hearing in Winnipeg?
Oh, Winnipeg has so embraced it. I'm delighted. You know, beautiful open minds. And we all know, you know, like I was saying, everybody's recognizing that we really need to honor this sacred, beautiful aspect of our bodies and of our lives.
And do you see this festival as being different depending on your sexuality or gender?
I don't.
Either of you?
I don't think so. I've never thought of that, but I don't. It's welcomes to all, you know, sexual orientations and all ages. And I haven't noticed anyone. I mean, transgender woman was speaking at the last Vancouver one, and she was delighted with it. Wow, a place she could be safe.
Yeah. And Alana, just as a final question, what do you want people to take away from your workshop?
I'm hoping that they will actually not feel alone and feel like they're the only one, and they can help even in that little 20-minute talk that I'm giving them, that they will let go a little bit of some of the shame and guilt, and that they will seek out either help through myself or some of the other practitioners that will be there.
Sounds very interesting. Thank you both for coming into the studio.
Thank you.
Thank you, Laurie.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Wendy Demos is the founder and organizer of the Sacred Sexual Music Festival. That's happening at the Park Theater on Sunday. And Alana Dane is a local certified sexologist, and she's speaking at the festival.